A very good morning to class 12th commerce. I welcome you in the accountancy class, and the today's topic is partnership accounts. Already in my previous video we have discussed over the two very important points, that is rules of partnership as per Partnership Act 1932. Already I have explained some rules related to practical questions. And I have also told that there are some changes in 2013. Changes. And the second thing I taught yesterday in my previous video, that was partnership deed. Partnership deed, which is known as Partnership Agreement. It is as per government rule, and this is partnership deed that is made by partners. Yesterday I told the minimum in my previous videos. I have already explained the number of partners as per Partnership Act, that was minimum 2 and maximum 20. But in 2013 there was some amendments, there were some changes according to Company Act 1956. These changes were made as per Company Act 1956. So the maximum number of partners, that is now 50. Today I will explain you the general entries related to the partnership business. How the partnership business is started, and what are the items of the are the transactions related to partners. So already we have discussed, so I am just removing this, and directly I will start the journal entries. My dear students, just here I am writing A, B and C. A, B and C, these are partners. A, B, C are partners. They started their partnership business. So any business that is required investment. So from there I will write the journal entries. The first journal entry. Journal entries. Journal entries regarding the partnership account. The first one, when A, B and C started business with capital. And that is in form of cash. The partnership business can be started directly with the cash or with the kinds, means assets can also be invested. So when ABC started business with capital, and that is cash, so the journal entry will be first cash or bank account. If they are maintaining cash account, So cash account will be affected if directly the banking transactions are there. So the bank account will be affected. Cash or bank account debit. And two, A, here I am writing in detail as capital account. To B's capital account and to C's capital account. Already you have learned in class 11 when a business is started, so we write cash account debit to capital account. Because there are three partners, so we have to maintain the capital account of the partner. Capital account of the partners. So the capital account will be made with three columns in the debit side and the three columns in the credit side. Here we can write the narration like this. This is the first gentleman. Second. As I have explained you that interest on capital that is not according to Partnership Act, but in the deed interest on capital can be allowed. So interest on partner's capital. Partners capital is allowed. Interest on capital is allowed. It is given to partners. Interest on capital, that is income for the partners, and that is expense for the business partnership firm. You keep this in your mind. Very important thing, that interest on partners' capital is allowed to partners, that is benefit for them, and that is expenditure for the partnership firm. So interest on partners' capital, this is a nominal account, as I have explained in the previous classes also. So the journal entry will be, here I am not making the pro forma. You can just understand in this way. You can, if you want to make the pro forma, that can be done. No problem. Interest on partner's capital. Interest on capital account debit. And two, A, B, and C's capital account. It is for A, B, and C. Listen, it is not any chemical expression. Simply, instead of writing S capital account, B's capital account, and C's capital account, I have written it together. So, interest on capital account debit to ABC. That amount will be credited to the partner's capital account in the credit side. Here we can write the narration. These are the two journal entries, my dear. Here I am writing the another. Interest on partner's capital account is allowed, and interest on partners drawing, interest on drawing, third entry, interest on drawings listen my dear, the very common term drawings, that is withdrawal of cash or goods by the partners. It was taught in class 11 that cash are goods withdrawn by the owner, trader, that is known for his personal use. Very important thing, when cash or goods is withdrawn by the owner or the partners for their personal use, that is known as drawings, and we maintain the drawings account. And as interest on partners, whatever is invested by partners, the firm gives interest on that capital to the partners. Just opposite of that, when the partners have withdrawn cash for their personal use, so interest on drawing is also charged. Interest on drawings, it is charged. Here I am just writing in small, it is charged. You just see, it is allowed, interest on partner's capital is allowed, and interest on drawings, that is charged. It is taken from the partners. So my dear students, I will write the journal entry, that is A, B and C's capital account debit, three amounts, and two interest on drawings. One amount I have written here. Is it clear? I have not explained one general entry. If I just I can just show here. See, third number. So that will become fourth number. Before this, I am just explaining, when partners have withdrawn